Okay, my dear students, welcome. I think we can start right now. First of all, I want to say hello. I hope you're doing very good. And welcome to our second online session. Okay, remember this is English Does Work Level 1. And I think we can start working. Okay, get me just one sec. Some people are getting into the meeting right here. Okay, that's good. Okay, so let me start by giving you some important information, okay? I'm gonna share my screen with you guys. This is like the boring part. Let me get it straight. Esta primera parte es un poquito como de información para que ustedes sepan qué es lo que tienen que hacer para la semana, bla, 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 okay? So it's a little bit boring, I would say, but we have to do it, okay? Remember, guys, remember that the platform that we're going to be working on, it's called Sajuna. It's spelled with a J, right? Se escribe Sajuna, but it's pronounced Sajuna, okay? Sajuna.sena.edu.co, right here, okay? You have it in here. So, let me get inside. People are still getting in here, okay? So you need to go enter to your course, okay? And this is the homepage, right? First thing to check, primera cosa para chequear en plataforma Sajuna, announcements or anuncios, right? The last announcement that I sent to you was this one, where basically I gave you all of the important details, you know, for this assignment. Aquí les doy como los puntos más importantes de esta asignación. So, just to make it shorter, para hacerlo un poco corto. Remember, el nombre de esta evidencia, it's called Let's Meet. It's a forum. Es un foro, right? So, this forum is available from... It started yesterday. Empezó el día de ayer, lunes 22 de abril. And it's going to be available until the 28th of April, hasta el 28 de abril, right? Es decir, una semana, from Monday to Sunday, right? A full week, you have to work on this assignment. Remember, recuerden que aunque dice que va del 22 al 28 de abril, eso es de acuerdo al cronograma. Yo en la primera sesión les dije, muchachos, absolutamente todas las evidencias están. Evidencias son los trabajos. Todas las evidencias están disponibles hasta la fecha límite de recepción de actividades, que es el 14 de mayo. Mi consejo es que vayan trabajando semana a semana para que no le quede todo al final. Okay, but it's up to you. It depends, no? Just it's up to you. Okay, important thing, announcements, right? Then you truly need to check another important thing, which is the information, like from this week. So you need to go to Actividad de Aprendizaje Guía, right? Recuerden que toda la información de lo que ustedes deben hacer para cada una de las semanas está en este archivo que se llama Guía de Aprendizaje. You click on it, so quick, I'm going to explain this to you again. You click here. Ya lo expliqué la clase pasada, pero lo voy a hacer rápido otra vez. So, you click here and, okay, the first part is just information here, and this is important. It says, materiales de formación a consultar. I told you that for this course, you are supposed to work on three different studying components. Para este curso, ustedes deben estudiar tres materiales para la redundancia, de estudio, right? The first one must be done. El primero ya debe estar listo, porque era de la semana pasada, la primera semana. It's called Hello, It's Nice to Meet You. Or in Spanish, Hola, Encantado de Conocerte. For this week, we expect you to study the second one, right? Esperamos que ustedes estudien el segundo, que se denomina Let's Introduce Ourselves. Or, in Spanish, presentemos. Este material se espera que se estudie para esta semana. So, first, you go Study the component. Primero ustedes van, localizan el componente de estudio, lo estudian y ahí sí vamos a hacer el foro de esta semana, right? This activity was set for last week. Esta se hizo la semana pasada. And here we're gonna go with the second one. It says photo, let's meet. Oops, here, okay? Look, this activity has two parts, right? I'm gonna go and read it as it is in here, okay? Bueno, entonces, así como para resumir un poco, esta es una actividad de tipo colaborativa. Se llama photo, let's meet, right? Y tiene dos partes. The first intervention, la primera, intervention is different in Spanish. La primera parte tiene que ver con dar mi presentación personal, okay? But you must be saying, okay, that's easy, right? Like, my name is, I'm XX years old, I'm from whatever place, I am a student, a teacher, I like to read, I like to travel, thank you very much. Yes, I mean, I know, yo sé que muchos ya lo saben hacer, pero justo hoy en clase les voy a dar unos tips para que hagan esa presentación un poco más, like English-like, you know, un poquito más, como, un poco más challenging, retadora, right? So, here are some prompts that you are supposed to add, right? Algunos punticos, ítems que ustedes deben ingresar como mínimo en esa presentación. Name, age, city of birth, city of residence, profession or studies, and interest in your free time. Okay? So the first part is just to provide my introduction. La primera parte es presentarme en ese foro, como tal, escribir, you know, es un ejercicio de escritura. Okay, se presenta. That's the first part. When it's done, ahora que usted ya se presentó, vamos con la segunda parte. Okay, it says intervención 2. Part 2. It says, realice seguimiento al foro, a su foro, and you also have to, like, leave some comments to two of your classmates' forums, right? Yo termino de introducir mi foro, de postear mi foro, e inmediatamente voy a buscar dos personas, dos compañeros de clase, los miro, que ya dejó su intervención ahí, su foro, lo leo, el foro de dos personas, y les dejo un comentario. Un comentario no es, ah, so good, that's so nice, oh, that's good, no. Comentario es que motive la participación. Oh, that's good, so you are from Bogotá, I'm from Bogotá too, what neighborhood you live in, oh, tú eres de Bogotá, yo también, oh, tú eres de Tunja, en qué barrio vives, o whatever, you know, you see, como comentarios que tengan preguntas para promover la participación, right? That's it. De la misma manera, yo debo estar pendiente de mi foro, porque así como yo dejé un comentario a dos personas, es posible que yo también reciba comentarios y yo debo responderlos, okay? That is how it is going to be graded. Así es como se va a calificar. What I leave in my own comment or forum, and also the comments that I provide to my classmates. Okay? So, be careful. Tiene dos partes. And that's it. No more. That's exactly what you have to do. Listen. You must be, like, asking to yourself. Se deben estar preguntando, bueno, ya sé que tengo que estudiar. ¿Dónde lo busco? Es muy fácil. Aquí, en la misma parte donde dice actividades de aprendizaje guía, right? Aquí tenemos el archivo que estábamos leyendo. Aquí tenemos los tres componentes de estudio. Componente formativo Hello, que fue de la semana pasada. Componente formativo Let's Introduce Ourselves, de esta semana. And the next one is for the next 2 weeks, right? And here, y aquí si sigo bajando, eso lo van a encontrar así cerradito. You have to click here, and you will have actividad de aprendizaje foro Let's Meet. You click here, you're going to be taken to the forum, and look, aquí ya tengo una persona que me respondió, Laura, y ya le di su comentario. You have to click here. Añadir un nuevo tema de debate. You click and you have. Asunto, I don't know, whatever. What you want to type. Forum participation. Okay, whatever. Whatever you want to put there. And here you go. You know, hello, blah, 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 blah. Okay? And when you're done, you click here, enviar al foro. And that's it. Okay? And that's it. That's all that you have to do. Esta es la primera parte que ustedes deben hacer. Recuerden que hay una parte de seguimiento y de la parte colaborativa con sus compañeros, dejarle los comentarios y responder los que les dejan a ustedes. Okay? Good. That is the explanation of what you are supposed to do. Now, let's go with some question time. Vamos con unos 5 minuticos de preguntas. ¿Qué preguntas tienen? ¿Qué dudas tienen? You can do it in Spanish, no problem. Jonathan, you have your hand up, so what questions do you have? No questions? All clear? Jonathan?
Good afternoon, teacher.
Hello, good afternoon.
Tengo una pregunta. ¿El foro se sube escrito o hay que realizar un video?
No. That is like a written activity. You have to type it in. You know? Es una actividad de escritura. Es escrito. No es un video.
Okay, profe, gracias.
Good, perfect. Any other
profe,
question?
O sea, en diapositivas, ¿sí?
No, not really. No tiene que ser diapositivas. No. Así como les acabo de mostrar, ustedes van aquí, añadir un tema de debate, tienen todo el espacio y aquí pueden hacer su intervención. Aquí mismo. ¿No? All of that. When you're done, you click on enviar al foro. Nope, you don't need to, no necesitan hacer diapositivas. Las diapositivas es para la actividad de la siguiente semana. Y entre 2 semanas es un video. Entonces, vamos, la primera fue un cuestionario. Esta es una actividad de escritura común y corriente. La próxima sí es diapositivas, la parte de diseño. Y después viene el video. Okay. It's good. Okay. So I think you have no more questions, right? Creo que no hay más preguntas. According to what I see here.
Profe.
Yes.
Hacemos el foro, pero en ese foro, ¿qué es lo que debemos hacer o escribir? Que no entendí.
Okay. So, according to the information that we have, de acuerdo a la información que tenemos en la guía de aprendizaje, la cual les acabo de mostrar, nos dice que ese foro, esta actividad, tiene 2 partes. La primera parte en la cual yo me presento, right? Ahí me dan unos aspectos mínimos. Nombre, edad, ciudad de nacimiento, ciudad de residencia, hobbies. Of course, in English. En inglés, claro está. Esta es la primera parte. Ahora yo les voy a dar, con el video que vamos a ver, unos pequeños tips para que hagan esa intervención un poco más elaborada. Esa es la primera parte. Y en la segunda parte, ¿qué es lo que yo voy a hacer? Voy a leer 2 presentaciones de 2 amigos, de 2 compañeros de clase diferentes, right? Y les voy a dejar algún comentario que motive la conversación, right? Hey, yo leo que mi compañero dice, yo vivo en Bogotá, y yo también vivo en Bogotá, no sé, ¿en qué barrio vives? Para que haya ese intercambio de información, right? De igual manera, yo debo estar pendiente de mi foro, porque posiblemente me vayan a escribir a mí también, y yo debo responder. ¿Ok? So basically, that is exactly what you have to do.
Okay.
Great, it's good. Okay, my dear students, now let's work. Look, we're gonna work on this video. Her name is Emma, and she's gonna give us very useful pieces of advice. Okay, very useful pieces of advice to work on our introduction. Para trabajar en nuestra presentación. Okay? Presentación, introduction in English. Okay? So I'm gonna be pausing the video. I'm gonna be highlighting some stuff. Okay? And that's it. Yo voy a ir pasando el video. Voy a ir haciendo unos comentarios en algunos aspectos que creo, yo considero, they are very important. Okay? So let's start.
There are three reasons why this is such an important
story. Can you listen?
Of course, we've got to introduce ourselves all
or you can't.
In lots of different contexts.
A ver, yo no los escucho. ¿Qué pasó?
No se escucha bien, profe.
Yes or no? La hora de. Hay que instalar de blockers, no puedo instalar los blockers porque si no, no me dan ciertos componentes de Meet, los necesito.
Well, hey there, I'm Emma.
Can you listen, guys?
English. Today I'm...
¿Pueden escuchar bien? Yes, yes, good. Que yo escucho bajito, quiero asegurarme que todo esté bien. Ok. So, let's go.
And there are three reasons why this is such an important skill to learn. Of course, we've got to introduce ourselves all the time, right? In lots of different contexts. So, spending the time getting your introduction right is going to help you and it's going to benefit you over and over and over again. And when you meet someone new, you will likely feel a little nervous. It's totally normal, right? But if you can get off to a good start,
guys, this is very important. Esto es muy importante. Guys, knowing how to introduce ourselves is very important because we can use it in many different contexts, right? Saber cómo presentarnos en inglés es muy importante porque lo podemos utilizar en muchos contextos diferentes. It is not just like at school or in this English course, but also at work, you know, like business context, you know, and if we know how to do it, it would be very nice, right? Si sabemos cómo hacerlo apropiadamente, posiblemente nos va a ser muy útil en muchos aspectos de nuestras vidas, okay? So we're gonna go with some tips, right? Vamos con ciertos tips. And we're gonna section it into different categories, okay?
So imagine hearing this question.
So,
tell us about yourself.
If somebody asks
and
you,
feeling cool,
tell me
cool,
about yourself.
As you reply. That is exactly what we're working
okay?
Today.
Guys, listen. If somebody tells you, si alguien te dice, hey, cuéntame de ti, ¿qué me puedes decir? I would like some, like one person, to answer that question to me, right? Les voy a hacer una pregunta a todos. Y el que quiera o la que quiera me responde. Con lo que tenga. Antes de ver el video. Okay. Tell me about yourself. Tell me about yourself. If you want to answer, raise your hand. If you're gonna answer, si quieren responder, alcen la manito. Tell me about yourself. Nobody? Nadie, nadie? Nadie, nadie, really, really? Oh, come on. Not even one? I don't believe it. Se escucha bajito. Yes, yo también lo escucho bajito. Let me see what's going on. Let me close it. Vamos a cerrarlo. Okay, guys, I don't want to continue until you actually try. No quiero continuar hasta que alguien diga, bueno, yo lo intento. Nobody? Really? No, I can't believe it, guys. No les creo. Introduce yourself. Preséntense. Somebody. Yo sé que ya lo saben hacer porque me lo han mostrado muchas veces. Come on, you can do it. No? Okay. No problem. So, you didn't want to practice, so I'm going to continue. No quisieron practicar, yo continuo.
Oh, hi there. I'm Emma from
Okay, I don't know what's wrong with that.
Today I'm going to
Okay,
teach you
guys, give me one sec. Regálenme un momento, no se me vayan a ir. Me voy a desconectar por un momento porque el audio se escucha un poco bajo. Ya verifiqué y todo está bien. Me desconecto, no se vayan, ya regreso. Hello guys, I'm sorry, but there is something not going well. I cannot activate my camera. I think I'm having some kind of issues with the platform right now. So I'm gonna continue the class with no camera on, okay? I'm really sorry about it. So let me go here and here. ¿Hay algún problema de con la aplicación que utilizo para grabar y no me está dejando activar la cámara? Voy a continuar sin utilizar la cámara, ¿ok? Laura, ¿tienes alguna pregunta? Sure, Darcy, you wanna go ahead and give us, like, introduce yourself? ¿Quieres presentarte? Go ahead. We'll listen to you. No, must be in English. No, no, no. I would like you to do it in English, not in Spanish. Not in Spanish, in English. Please. Go ahead, activate your microphone.
Hi. My name's Darcy Hernandez. I am from Colombia. I live in Nopsa. My birthday is on 29 April. I am a student. I study in SENA. I am organized and responsible. There are the people in my family. They are my husband, my baby, and me.
Okay.
My hobby is dancing and singing. Okay, sí, sí. My favorite sport is skating.
Skating.
And my free time, I also like reading. I do not like the cats. My favorite food is pizza. My favorite drink is soda. My favorite day of the week is Sunday because I spend time with my husband. My favorite singer is Paola Jara.
Okay.
Y ya.
Okay, that's good. How old are you, Darcy?
Perdón?
How old are you?
No.
Your age. I am 34 years old. How old are you?
Bien.
¿Sigue? I am 34 years old. Yo tengo 34 años de edad. How old are you?
Ah, okay. I am
19 years old. 19. Darcy, you did it very good. Thank you very much for introducing yourself. That was cool. That was organized. That was pretty well structured, which is good. So that is exactly what we're going to be working on with this video, okay? That is exactly what we're going to be working on. So, ¿qué vamos a hacer con el video que vamos a ver? So, we're going to start by giving you some tips, okay? Voy a empezar dándole algunos tips, right? So, let's work on this.
Emma from...
the audio is not very good. I don't know why it's not working. No sé por qué, qué es lo que está pasando con esto, pero vamos a... Yo les voy a ir dando la información.
So let's get started with
okay.
your introduction.
First, we're going to start
how
with
we start?
Who.
We start really
right? Who.
Casually.
Who means quién? I mean, who
I
are you?
Emma,
¿quién eres
or
tú?
I'm Emma.
I can use I am
most situations
or I
can
use I'm. Right? It's the same. I'm is a little bit more informal. Or you could
Emma,
go with my name is.
Simple,
my
right?
names.
Got this.
Okay? So you have different ways of doing it. For example, in my personal case, I'm gonna take myself as an example, okay? Me voy a tomar como ejemplo. So, I'm gonna go with un poquito más informal. I'm Leonardo. I'm Leonardo, Ryan. So,
what if you have a preferred
simple,
name or a nickname?
You see?
It is always
Look,
good to let
if
the
maybe
your
my
address.
Friends
no,
called me differently,
right?
Right? Si mis amigos me llaman diferente,
say,
as it is the case, you know?
Me.
Look, my friends call me
my name is
Leo.
Jacobis, but my friends are
I'm Leonardo, but my friends call me Leo. Right? My friends call me Leo. Mis amigos me llaman Leo. Right? Okay? That is the first part. One example. She says, el ejemplo que ella nos da, my name is, that's very difficult, Biscay. But it's hard for some people to say it. Right? Pero es difícil que algunas personas lo digan. So you can call me Bis or Bice. Okay? So, you can call me. My friends call me. Mis amigos me llaman. Tú me puedes llamar. Okay? Let's continue. Remember, the first one is who. Who you are. Right? ¿Quién es usted? I'm Leonardo. Right? But my friends call me Leo. Second, where? Where? ¿Dónde? ¿Dónde qué? Where are you from? ¿De dónde vienes? You know, I can say I'm from Colombia.
Sounds just a little
right? I'm from Colombia. Simple. I'm from Colombia. Or if I want, also, I could say I come from. It's basically the same. I'm from Colombia or I come from Colombia, right? Or I can use a city. O puedo utilizar una ciudad. I am from Campo Alegre or I come from Campo Alegre, right? You can go with cities. Si estamos en el territorio nacional, pues obviamente ciudad, ¿no? But if we are like abroad in another country, we go with our country, which is Colombia, right? So it's up to you. Here, important.
So
hay unas cositas que es bueno que sepan. Look, here. If you want to be clearer, all you need to do is just I can also use other expressions.
You could say,
puedo utilizar otras expresiones.
I was born in.
Right?
In.
Fui nacido
or
en.
Even,
o sea, nací
I
en. I was born in. Look.
You could say
I was born in Campo Alegre. Yo nací en Campo Alegre. Or I can go with
I was born in Melbourne.
I grew up in
or
I was raised in or
even, I spent
my childhood in. All of them mean the same thing. Todos quieren decir lo mismo. Yo crecí en, yo fui criado en, yo pasé mi infancia en, right? I grew up in, I was raised in, I spent my childhood in.
And a place.
So,
so
I can use any of them.
Child,
puedo utilizar cualquiera de esas expresiones, you know?
You
if you don't want to go with the typical I am from or I come from, you can use
really
any of them,
so
you know? Si no quieren utilizar las mismas, enriquecer su
vocabulario,
so you can go with that. Look at the example. El ejemplo que nos da ella. I was born in Australia and I spent my childhood growing up in various cities along the East Coast. Yo nací en Australia, pero pasé mi infancia creciendo en diferentes ciudades de la costa este. Okay? Could be.
Along the East Coast.
Okay.
I'm originally
Look.
From Melbourne.
Now, let's go with number three.
Really
okay, the next one. The next one.
So
it's about. Oops, sorry. It's about family.
What's
the
up?
Next
I'm
one
Kara.
Is about
we
family.
We brought you here today.
Now, you might want to talk about your family a little bit when you introduce yourself.
Hablar de la familia. So remember, the first one. Who? La primera es, primer tip, first tip, who? ¿Quién es usted? My name is Leonardo, I'm Leonardo, but my friends call me Leo. Second, where? I was born in Campo Alegre, and I grew up in Campo Alegre as well. Okay. Third, family.
That you share here is up to you, whatever you feel comfortable.
Let's see what we have family here.
Be careful not to overshare, you know, to bore someone with your
okay,
entire
this
family.
Is pretty, this is pretty nice because
married,
we can go with
say,
this. Look.
We're a family of five.
Somos cinco en mi familia, somos diez en mi familia, somos una familia de diez. So basically, in English, we have to say like, we are a family of, and the number of members of your family. Okay? For example, me, I have my mom, my dad, my sister, my brother, and me. So it's five. So we are a family of five. We are a family of five.
I live here with my family.
I live here with my family. We are a
family
of five.
Then you need
look,
to clarify, you need to say,
also
grew up.
You can say, I grew up in a family of. Yo crecí en una familia de, in my case, five. I grew up in a family of five. Okay? So, that is the structure to follow. Okay? Good. Vocabulary about family. Look. Most of you, you have kids, you have sons, you have daughters, right? ¿Algún vocabulario que podemos utilizar con la descripción de las familias o los miembros de la familia that I have, right? For example, I don't have kids. Yo no tengo hijos, you know. I have two dogs. Tengo dos perros. Like, I love them so much. And so I could say, I have a 7-year-old son. Yo tengo un hijo de 7 años de edad. En inglés se utiliza mucho esa estructura. I have a, la edad, y después lo que se tiene cuando hablamos de personas, ¿no? Hijos, hijas. I have a 7-year-old son. I have a 7-year-old daughter, you know? Son, hijo, daughter, hija. The second, I'm a single parent. Most of us, muchos de ustedes, de pronto son padres solteros, right? So, I'm a single parent. I'm a single father. I'm a single mother. You know, I'm a single, soltero, single. Number three, I'm a mother of twins. Soy mamá o papá. I'm a father. I'm a mother of twins, de gemelos. Or I'm a mother of two. Soy mamá de dos. ¿De dos qué? Pues de dos chicos, hijos. Okay? That's it. Okay? More vocabulary. Look, this is vital. Esta palabra no sé por qué no la conocemos mucho y es muy usada y muy pertinente. Siblings. 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 Right? Siblings means hermanos. Girls and boys. Both together. Right? In Spanish, I say, me preguntan in Spanish, Leonardo, ¿tienes hermanos? Sí, yo tengo dos hermanos. Pero los dos pueden ser hombres o un hombre o una mujer. ¿Cierto? En inglés, si yo digo brothers, los dos son, o bueno, los que tenga, son hombres. Sisters son mujeres. Siblings joined like the both of them. Siblings me une los dos, tanto femenino como masculino. Siblings. In my case, I have two siblings. One sister and one brother, me. Okay, I have two siblings, one sister and one brother.
Two brothers and a sister.
Okay, some other vocabulary here, not important. Next, so remember, first, el primero, who, right? Two, where? Three, family. Primero, ¿quién es usted? Segundo, ¿de dónde es? Where? Then, family, hablar de la familia. Now, let's talk about interests. Intereses. I mean, things that you like to do. Las cosas que les gustan hacer. Okay, we have some vocabulary here. Basically, we can use three verbs to express our interests. The first one is with the verb enjoy. Okay? Enjoy. Enjoy.
Joy as a verb is
look, I enjoy. I enjoy teaching. Yo disfruto enseñar. I enjoy working out. Disfruto ejercitarme. I enjoy traveling. Si se dan cuenta, después del enjoy, the verb must go in ing. El verbo va en ing. I enjoy traveling. I enjoy swimming. I enjoy working. I enjoy partying. I enjoy dancing. Things that you like to do. I enjoy baking. Enjoy.
It's followed by a noun. And this is a gerund. Okay? You can always say I
another
like
verb
it,
that we
I
can
love
use is love.
So I love.
Love. I love playing football. I love
the
exercising.
Like love,
so basically it's the same stuff. Right?
And
or you can also use like.
Love to play.
Enjoy. Love,
exactly.
Like.
You could say,
okay?
I'm really into.
And this is very important. Look, this is expression is really used. Esta expresión es muy utilizada y casi no nos la enseñan aquí en Colombia. I'm really into. I'm really into. If I like, I do CrossFit. Yo hago CrossFit, me gusta mucho. Entonces yo voy a decir, me encanta el CrossFit. Entonces, una expresión que yo puedo utilizar es esa. I'm really into CrossFit. Que me encanta mucho el CrossFit. Si me gusta viajar, I'm really into... Bueno, ahí sería traveling. Pero no se puede porque es un verbo. So, I'm really into pottery. Me gusta mucho la cerámica, hacer cositas en cerámica, ¿ok? I'm really into, I don't know, things that you like, you know, social media. Me gustan mucho las redes sociales, pero no es mi caso, pero, okay, so, things, you know, I'm really into.
And this is a really great, a really
it's a very nice expression. Okay, I'm really into jazz music. Okay, so that's it. That is good. So, remember, first, ¿qué era lo primero? El primer tip sobre qué era. First, who. Very good. Who, quién, quién es usted. Second, where. Very good. ¿De dónde es usted? Then, number three, family. Very good. It's about family, right? Four. Interests. Intereses, right? Hobbies. Things that you enjoy doing. And the last one, el último,
job,
is going to be
jobs. So when you're
jobs.
Talking about your job, when you're
jobs.
Talking about your job,
it means trabajo, su trabajo,
usually
right?
You're just sharing.
So,
do and maybe
we're gonna go
again,
with some things here.
Work,
look,
the
it's pretty easy. You
so
can go with I am. I am. Yo soy. And your job position. Y la posición que ustedes tienen. In my case, I am an English language teacher. Si yo fuera ingeniero, I am an engineer. Si fuera, I don't know, si fuera psicólogo, I am a psychologist, right? Or a therapist, okay?
Need to include
so that's
an
it.
I'm a graphic designer, I'm an engineer.
I'm
just make sure you're not saying I'm
okay.
Engineer. That's wrong.
I'm a.
And
I
if there's am. Only one of your
okay?
role within
that's
the company,
crucial.
Then you definitely
okay. Look, if you wanna say the name of the company, oh no, wait, first, antes de eso. Also, you can say, yo puedo decir, yo soy profesor, o yo puedo decir, yo trabajo en educación, right? I could go with, I work in education. Yo trabajo en educación. Si yo trabajara en la construcción, I work in construction. If I worked, si yo trabajara en, no sé, en el diseño, I work in designing or design. Okay? So,
I work in
marketing.
I work in
construction.
I work in design.
I work in.
Which company,
and if I want to mention the company I work for,
either,
la compañía para la cual yo trabajo. Okay? I work at Sena, or I work for Sena.
You
know, it's exactly
the
same.
You see,
so you might say, I work at
Sena. I work at Sena. I work for Sena. No problem.
I work for
the government.
Do you work for yourself?
I work for an international, whatever company. You know?
In this
so, look, muchos de ustedes son independientes. Most of you, you don't work for like any company. But you work, you know, like you are your own, like chiefs and bosses and stuff, right?
You could say
I work for myself.
I'm
or
self-employed,
I'm self-employed.
I run my own business.
I run my own business. Pero cómo así, si run es correr, también es manejar, manejar de llevar las riendas de algo, right? I run my own business. I am self-employed. I work for Sena.
Here's a little hint. If you're unsure about how to talk about your job in your industry,
okay,
as it relates to
so,
your industry,
pretty useful vocabulary.
Others.
Pretty useful vocabulary. And finally, the last one, the last tip is about
education.
Educación.
Or the qualifications in your introduction. And
okay.
This is most common
that's
in
good.
Professional
so,
context, maybe in
let's see some
you
vocabulary.
Can say,
you can go with when you're con.
I have a degree in.
Yo tengo un título universitario degree. I have a degree in industry and the industry. In my case, I have a degree in education. Okay, I have a degree in marketing.
An industry.
I have a degree in engineering.
Design. I have a degree
okay.
in engineering. You can also
simple.
Say I'm a qualified.
Another expression. I am a qualified teacher, architect, doctor. Se qualified es como con una cualificación, es como con un título universitario. I'm a qualified, you know? I'm a qualified and whatever thing. Okay, look, for you guys, that maybe most of you are taking this course, muchos de ustedes toman este curso, pueden utilizar esa expresión. Like, it's like a kind of training, you know? Es como un curso de entrenamiento. I'm currently taking an online English course with Sena. I'm currently taking an online English course with Sena. Good.
Or I'm doing
you see?
An extra
and that's it. So, remember, guys, we talk about who you are, quiénes son, where are you from, de dónde son. We talk about family, hablamos de su familia. We also talk about your interests, hablamos de sus intereses. We talk about your job, you know, and we also talk about education. Okay? So, as simple as that. Now, look, if you see here, I'm going to send you this link later on. Ahora les envío este link. Gonna do something right now. I'm gonna send you the link from the video right now. En este momento les acabo de hacer el envío del link del video que utilizamos. Si ustedes lo quieren ver, repasar. ¿Listo? And now I'm gonna explain this activity. This is a very short activity. Look, this activity, guys, as you can see here, okay, this is called a Padlet. Esto es un Padlet. No sé si lo hayan manejado anteriormente. Es como un tablero online donde todos podemos poner cositas, right? So, here, You have the video. Ahí tienen el video again. If you click here, you're gonna watch the video, you know, here.
Oh, hi there, I'm Emma.
That's it. And here you have like a recap of the most important expressions and data from the video. Yo aquí les saqué como un pequeño resumen. Oops. No, don't go.
I'm Emma from...
Oh, come on. Aquí les puse un pequeño resumen de las expresiones por cada uno de los ítems. Who? ¿Quién es usted? I'm. My name is. Preferred nickname. ¿Cómo quiere que lo llamen? Oh, my friends all call me. You can call me. Where? I'm. And the nationality. I'm from the country or the city. Family. I'm married. I'm single. You see, you have everything in here. Tienen todo aquí. Now, what are you going to do? ¿Qué van a hacer? In 5 minutes, en 5 minuticos, lo que alcancen a hacer en 5 minutos, you're going to leave a comment here. Me van a dejar un comentario introduciéndose, presentándose, like introducing yourself, presentándose ustedes aquí. Aquí tenemos dos ejemplos. Ya les digo cómo lo van a hacer. Look, le damos a Linda. Hello. I'm Linda Sofía Hernández. You can call me Sophie. Lo único que yo le pondría aquí son punticos, signos de puntuación. So, hello, I'm Linda Sofía Hernández. You can call me Sophie. I'm 14 years old. I was born in Garzón Huila, but I was living with my grandparents for 7 months. We are a family of 5 people, my parents and my siblings. I love reading, watching TV, and in my free time, I practice English. I'm currently taking an English online course. Ella lo hizo así, pues no metió todo, está bien. Look, esta me la acabaron de poner ahí. Fue la clase que acabamos de terminar, que acabé de terminar. Hi, my name is Viviana Mogollón. My friends all call me Vigis. I grew up in Firavitoba. I'm single. We are a family of 5. I like draw and listen to music. I don't do sports. I love sleeping. I'm studying. Okay, es un poquito más simple, pero está bien. Okay, so here, as you can see, si ven aquí, aquí en la parte de abajo hay un signo de más. There is a plus icon. You click here. And you're gonna have the spot for you to enter your comment. Okay, you put your name, Pepito Pérez. Okay, and here you can do it. Cancel. You can do it. You can do it. Here. And when it's done, you can go on publish. Aquí pueden poner un link. Para si lo usan para otras cosas, ¿no? Sus trabajos, no sé, un link, una foto, whatever. Publish, and here it's gonna be. Right? So I'm gonna send you the link. Les voy a enviar el link. In 5 minutes. Lo que alcancen a hacer in 5 minutes. Do it. And I'll reach you. Y los leo. 5 minutes. If you noticed, this is basically the same that you have to do for this week's assignment. Si se dan cuenta, eso que estamos haciendo acá es lo mismo que tienen que hacer en la asignación de la semana. Entonces, si pusieron cuidado, tomaron apuntes, ahí tienen el link, los tips, tienen ya casi prácticamente el 60% o 70% del trabajo hecho. 3 more minutes. Okay, guys, do I have any comment here? ¿Tengo algún comentario por aquí? Let me see. Okay, Andrea, Anderson Ortiz. Okay, Anderson says. Okay, I have more. Is that from here? Okay, good afternoon. My name is Anderson Ortiz. I am 22 years old. I'm from Colombia. I like soccer and I'm very responsible in what I do. I am very punctual. My friends tell me to walk, Andres. I don't get the second part. It's not bad, it's good. Anderson, no está mal, está bien. Pero creo que puedes ajustar un poco más de acuerdo a los tips que el video nos dio. Okay? But it's not bad, it's good. I don't get the last part. No entiendo la última parte, but... Okay. Hello, my name is Andrea. I was born in Venezuela and I live in Tunja. Ah, okay, it's pretty simple, you know, está bien, pero está un poco simple. Recuerden utilizar todos los tips que vimos en el video. Okay, hi, my name is Maria Fernanda. You can call me Mafe. I'm 16 years old. I'm from Bogota, Colombia. I study system engineering at the Cooperativa University of Colombia. I like to exercise, run in the morning, put on makeup, groom myself. I live with my sister and my pet Lila. That's pretty, like, more complete. That's good. Está un poco más completo, más estructurado. It's good, of course. Yeah, that's good. That's good. I think it's okay. Next. Hi there. I'm Oscar Duran. I have 32 years old and I'm from Campo Alegre. Also, at the moment, I'm living in Bogota. I'm okay, a psychologist and work with the health ministry. Also, I like training in the gym, sleep, hiking. That's good. So, Oscar, one thing, I'm gonna edit it here. Oscar, one thing, remember, I'm Oscar Duran. Remember that in English, en español expresamos la edad con el verbo tener, yo tengo, ¿cierto? Yo tengo 32, tengo 34, tengo 40, pero en inglés no utilizamos el verbo tener para expresar la edad. En inglés diríamos algo como yo estoy de tantos años. Entonces, por eso sería no have, but am. I am 32 years old and I am, yo soy de, te faltó el soy, yo de, I am from Campo Alegre. Also, at the moment, I am living in Bogota. I'm, recuerde, en español podemos decir yo soy psicólogo, yo soy profesor. También podemos decir, yo soy un psicólogo, yo soy un profesor, right? En inglés, debemos utilizar el artículo, un, a. So, I'm a psychologist and work for the health ministry. Right? Ministering. Okay. Also, I like training in the gym. El verbo es like, y decimos training, todos los verbos que van ligados a like van con ing. I like training in the gym, sleeping, hiking, etc. That's good. Oscar, you did it very good. I think you can improve it a little bit more. Puedes utilizar algo del título que tienes, you know. De pronto hablar acerca de tu familia un poco. But it's good. It's very good. Jonathan Blanco. Hello, my name is Jonathan Blanco. My friends all call me Tatán. I'm from Socotá, Boyacá. I'm favorite single rock in Spanish. I'm favorite single rock. Yo soy favorito. I don't get it. Jonathan, I don't get that part. No entiendo esa parte. Tienes que revisarla. Okay. We are a family of five. I like food, hot dogs. I love sports, basketball. Basketball se escribe, en inglés se escribe con K. Basketball. I work in cooking or chef. Very good. I love reading. That's good. Very good. Jonathan, it's good. Algunos ajustes, pero está bien. Okay. Hi, my name is Valeria Gomez, but my friends can call me Vali. I'm 17. Okay. Acá Valeria me dice, I'm 17 old. Okay. I am 17 years old. Years old. Okay. I'm 17 years old. I was born in Cali, Colombia, but actually, okay. Actually, es como decir en español, ¿verdad? Actually, actualmente es currently. Te la voy a corregir ahí para que la puedas corregir después. Currently live in Palmira. Okay. I grew up in a family of five. I have three pets. Their names are... Okay, como son tres nombres, no es is, es are, son, no es. Okay? I have three pets. Their names are Luna, Love, and Bella. I'm studying software programming and English. Very good. It's good. Valeria, está bien, algunos ajustes. Okay, let me go with two more. Vamos con dos más porque se nos acabó el tiempo. Hi, my name is Marisol Pacanchique, Boyacá. O sea, son sus apellidos. My friends all call me Mari. I'm 17 years old. I'm from Tunja. I live in Sichoque. I like playing basketball. I am studying at Sena. Recuerda utilizar los signos de puntuación, right? Revisa el vocabulario porque hay cositas para ajustar. Y el último, hi, I'm Julian. You can call me Julian. I am Colombian. I am married. We are a family of three, my wife, my daughter, and me. I like to work. Dos verbos en inglés no pueden ir pegados o se separan con el to cuando puedo o con el ing el segundo cuando puedo, dependiendo de las reglas. El like me deja hacerlo de las dos maneras. I like to work or I like working. I work in operational assistant. I work as a, como asistente operativo. Okay, that's good. Perfect. Guys, you did it good. You did it pretty nice. It was good. So, my advice before finishing. Mi consejo, revisen ese video una vez más. Miren que yo les saqué todo como una pequeña lista. Modifiquen, mejoren sus intervenciones. Y exactamente eso es lo que pueden poner en Sajuna. Right? Sajuna. Sajuna. Okay? That's it. I think we have reached the end of our class. Creo que hemos alcanzado el final de nuestra clase. Questions, pregunticas. La grabación va a estar mañana disponible. Vamos a ver qué fue lo que pasó con el audio porque no sé qué pasó. Questions. All good? ¿No hay preguntas? Okay, my dear students, so that's it for today. Thank you very much for coming. If you have any questions, you can reach me at my email account. Si tienen alguna pregunta, me escriben al correo electrónico con mucho gusto. Tengo unos correos sin responder de que me enviaron el día de ayer. Tan pronto termine, me pongo a eso. And that's it. See you next week. Bye bye. Bye guys, bye bye, take care.